Did you know that you can build a vault outside? Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is your friendly neighborhood Oxhorn, and today we're going to build an outdoor vault here at the Boston Airport. I'm on a second character here. This is not my main. So I have all of my settlement slots free, and so I figured I would go ahead and experiment with building a vault here. Now, before the vault tile sets open up, you do have to complete the quests related to Vault 88. Once done, the entire vault tile set opens up, and to my knowledge, there's no settlement restriction. I mean, here I am at the Boston Airport, which is a notoriously restricted settlement, and yet I'm still free to use the build pieces. I've tried this at the Murkwater construction site as well, and I was able to use all pieces. So, I don't know of any settlements that are restricted, but if you do, please let me know in the comments of this video. So what I figured we would do is spend 30 minutes, I'm gonna try to keep this under 30 minutes, to build the shell of a vault with rooms on the inside and a functioning door. And to do that, we need to put some supports. So it's really important that you get your supports right the first time, because the supports are gonna snap to each other, and then that's gonna basically dictate how straight everything is. So going along here, and I definitely see that there's a bit, it's not quite straight enough. That's slightly narrower than that. Now, these supports are not strictly necessary, but the reason we're doing that is because there's all this trash around here that I could not scrap. I can't scrap these barricades. There's a lot of bricks and stuff on the ground, and, you know, I don't want hovering pieces. So I'm building this support structure just so that I can have it rise above the ground. And I think that's pretty straight. So let's rise that up. And I don't have a jetpack on this character, so that's going to make building a little harder. Okay, and that's looking good. All right, let's snap the rest together. Okay, you can see where I'm going with this, right? I'm just trying to lay a foundation here that we can build upon. That's going to make our lives a lot easier later on. All right, this one is a little tricky. Doesn't want to slide on in there, so let's try this piece. This is infuriating. Ah. All right, let's build the rest first. Maybe we'll get lucky later on. All right, this is just getting really finicky, so. And just for the record, I don't have any mods installed right now that help with this. If I had the Place Anywhere mod installed, this would be so much easier. Okay, I got it to work. I stopped recording while I figured this out. I wasn't going to make you sit through me trying to figure it out. But basically, the game doesn't like it when you build a border and then start filling in the middle. It really prefers it if you go line by line by line. Just kind of stacking them like laying bricks. That's how I got it to work anyway. But so there we go. We've got our platform. That's going to be nice. Now we need to get a door. And let's use the new door that came with the Vault-Tec Workshop. So let's go to Structures, Doors, and look at this amazing thing. Look how beautiful it is. All right, now there are a few things I am trying to figure out. So already the issue is that this is just going to kind of sit on this platform, and I'm not sure how it snaps. Also, so that's good to know. It doesn't actually need power, which is odd. You would think it needs power, but it doesn't. It doesn't need power. So we need to get a ladder on up into here. And, ooh, it snaps to the top. Cool. Cool, it snaps to the top. All right, so that's good to know. I'll go ahead and get that around there later. So let's go ahead and get a ladder down on in here. Oh, man. Gosh, so the reason I'm not using my Place Anywhere mod is because a recent update to the game broke it, and I'm waiting on an update from that particular mod author. Place Anywhere would allow me to get a ladder to work, because this doesn't want to sink into the ground. So let's just use a regular ladder that comes with either the barn or the warehouse tile sets. You see how these sink into the ground? Why do these ladders sink into the ground for easy placement, but the other ones don't? I don't get it. Alright, can I get this over here somewhere? And no. It's not going to want to place because of... yeah, because of that. So, okay. Well, then let's make the entrance over here in this corner. There we go. And then, snap this bad boy. Oh, please don't be finicky. Doesn't want to do this right. So it's one thing to snap lengthwise. And yet I want it here. Okay. So, it's wanting to snap lengthwise, and yet I don't have room. Actually, I do have room over there if I wanted to make the entrance over there. I kind of still really want the entrance to be over there, though, so... well, that's okay. Let's move our ladder, because that'll just make things easier. And let's make our entrance right here. Golly! Alright, and now... this should snap? Why? Why are you do this? So I don't want it to snap like this because this is the wrong way. I mean, this is where the door is stored. That needs to be on the inside. So I don't want it to snap that way. I want it to snap this way. Like, yeah, like that. Hold on. Okay, that's the best I'm gonna get. Okay! And no, that's wrong. That's wrong. All right, so I thought that this was the inside, but this is clearly the outside. And I thought that because you wouldn't want the door stored in an outside container. So we actually need to switch this around again. Which should be okay, because it prefers to be switched around anyway. And then we can move this over here. We'll move that later. Okay, so we've got our door. Now let's start working on the actual structure itself. So the atrium comes with these big atrium prefabs. I'm not going to use them because, as you can see, it's got this sort of concave ceiling. And in my mind, that's designed to fit the contours of a really large interior cave wall. But we don't have that here. We just have a nice regular outdoor open area. So I would prefer to build a square structure. So let's decide where we want our... I want this area to be my atrium, and then I want some domestic areas over here. So let's build our stairway first. Here we go. Is this going to snap to anything? No, it's not. So we're not going to build our atrium first. Instead, we're going to build our floors first. So let's go to atrium, floors. It's just going to make our lives a lot easier. Now, can this... Looks like it does want to snap on down in there. I don't know, part of me thinks that this should snap a little higher. But that looks alright. So we'll just go with that for now. We can always use the trim. Let's see, where's the trim? There's the trim. The trim should work on the floor. There. There we go. That's going to make it look a lot better. Okay. Looking good. All right. So let's go back to our floors. And we're basically just trying to place down floors so that we can connect to something with our stairs. Go to domestic. There's our stairs. And there we go. Now we need to support our stairs. So let's go to supports and let's grab the correct stairway support, which I believe is this one. There we go. Alright, how many floors do I want this little vault to be? It's just going to be a tiny vault, you know, it's not that big. The Boston Airport is a great little location for this, though. Let's make it a three-story vault. So let's go back to our atrium and go to floors. Connect a floor there and a floor there. And then we can go back to domestic and grab another stairway. And that just stacks right on top of that. Looking great. Now let's figure out, let's see. We need to have some domestic rooms. Since this is such a smaller space than our actual vault, we need some domestic rooms and maybe one room for a cafeteria. And then just a big open space where we can put crops. Well, actually, no, we could put the crops outside here. We don't need everything in the vault. So this is mainly going to be a living space and maybe a working space. So let's go to... Let's build some bedrooms. And I think the bedrooms are going to be on the top floors. So let's go to domestic hallway. Let's get rid of these floors because we don't need them right now. Let's go to... doorway end cap. Let's place those there. I'll figure that one out later. And then let's go to domestic hallway and doorway. That gives me one doorway there, and then that goes out to the hallway. I want this area to be open, so that's why I'm putting a wall there. And then this is going to be a... What I really want is a hallway, doorway, corner. But I don't think the toolset comes with that, no. So what I'll do is I'll do the exact same thing, hallway and doorway. And then we're going to need to put... an end cap on there. Because we don't want that leading out to the open. So, all the way to the end, grab the end cap. Ooh. Something's wrong. Oh well, we will figure that out later. Anyway, let's build out the rest of this section. So I'm gonna want a hallway and doorway. Let's see, I'll have one room there. Okay, one, two, one, two. Perfect. So that gives me enough for two rooms on that side. So a doorway there, and then just a regular domestic hallway here. And then a doorway here, and then a hallway here. And then that should work with an end cap piece. Yeah. See, it works there. I'm not sure why it doesn't want to work here. That's weird. Okay. So now we need to connect up our rooms. So that connects to a doorway. Let's go to our rooms section. And we've got common rooms, luxury rooms. Let's just go to regular quarters here, and we can choose the wallpaper we like. Now, let's go with this one. Perfect. Let's make sure we've choose the right wallpaper for the rest of this. So we're gonna need a corner and a corner and a corner. Then let's find another wallpaper, because we don't want the same thing over and over again. Now we like a little bit of diversity here on the program. So diversity in the true sense of the word, of course, not necessarily the politically correct sense of the word. All right, now we need to find, there we go. Actually, that could be a little deeper, couldn't it? Yeah, that could be a little deeper. So I'm gonna set this over here. We don't want our settlers to be too crowded. So let's build out the walls a little bit. Let's see, is this the right wallpaper? No. There we go. So that's the middle wall. And then we can start building the final corners. Here's one. And that one's nice. It's got a window. There we go. So that's room number one. Let's do room number two. Oh my gosh, I've already hit my size limit. How did I do that? I scrapped everything in here. I've already hit my size limit? Well, what could possibly be taking up all my budget? I scrapped absolutely everything. Well, we're going to have to use a mod to get over that, so I've got a bat file installed that's going to help with this, so I'm going to go bat, settlement, and bam! Eat that, Bethesda! Settlement budget expended, my tuckus. There we go, there's the middle wall pieces. And then I can round this off. Okay, now we need to support it. So let's go back to our supports. And it's a single story support. Actually, I suppose we could build on in here. Oh yeah, that's right. This is where I want to build a cafeteria of some sort, right? Yeah, so I'm not going to support that. All right, let's go upstairs and see how it looks. All right, room number one with a nice corner window view of downtown Boston. Pretty cool. Room corner number two with the window out here looking at concrete. Nice. All right, so it worked. Great, so we know what we're going to be doing there. I kind of want to see what the finished version of the interior space is going to look like, especially since we're running out of time. So let's build up the walls here. And I said earlier that I didn't want to use these atrium prefabs. So instead, what we want to do is just build up using these corner pieces. So let's remove this. And we'll just build around the floor. Oh, for Pete's sake. There we go. Nice window right here to take a look at the workshop. And then let's just get some regular walls. Oh my gosh. Why? Why? This is clearly not what I want to do. Why are you doing that? Yes! Oh, I got it, finally. Oh man, is this gonna be the way it is? No! Yes. Yes, all right, quarter piece. Goodness gracious. All right, another floor and wall combo. Oh, for Pete's sake. All right, I'm just going to build this wall. I'll be right back. Okay, I didn't want you to have to sit through that nonsense. So what we're going to do here, hold on, let me turn on my lamp so we can have a little bit more light because of the shadow here. What we want to do here is we want this vault door to enter the atrium. And that leaves us with this weird kind of harsh cutoff there. So let's store that floor there. And let's actually get a floor corner piece. That's going to make this look a lot nicer. There we go. And we'll do the same over here. Nice. Great. So we've got our wall all the way around. Now let's build out our cafeteria. I figure this bottom floor will be a cafeteria because everybody needs to eat. Just like everybody needs to poop. So let's go on over and build this wall with a door so that we can then go to the rooms, go to the cafeteria, and find the wall prefab and snap it. Oh, for... there we go. Gosh, when you, sorry for complaining so much, ladies and gentlemen. I get spoiled. I've been spoiled because I've been playing with mods, and that just makes my life easier. And then I get spoiled, and then when I have to play without mods, I just become this frustrated, petulant child, which is a bad character trait. I understand. No! Come on! The one way I want this! You're doing every single way, but the way I want this! Oh, no, no. Come on, please. Just, yes, yes. Oh. I'm sorry. I need to become more sanguine. Okay, then let's get just a wall. We don't need a window in every corner. I like this wall. This cafeteria tile set comes with some walls that have these nice food decals on them, which I think is pretty cool. And then let's get one more corner here. Don't need to have a doorway, just a regular corner. Let's get some windows up in here. And a corner. And then we don't need windows for this one because that's just a boring So there are two cafeteria walls with different decals. One has the hot dog, the sub, and the french fries. The other has the burger, the pizza, and the pretzel. And then they have one that's blank, like that one. Okay, looks like our cafeteria is looking good. Let's get this this middle one with the floating ceiling. And that finishes that off. Sweet. Now, let's match all this up so it looks good. We don't need that anymore. So let's go to the atrium and get a corner piece. Corner. There we go. Because we want to hide this pink wall. Because pink walls don't look like atrium walls. Looking good. Okay, let's decide exactly how tall we want our atrium, and it looks like this decision has been made for us because we have that other floor up there. So let's get some middle walls and let's just go all the way around. Then we don't have to do that back section because that's covered by the domestic units. Oh, good. I was afraid this was going to give me problems, but it's not. It's making my life really easy. Sweet, and then we'll finish this off for the third and final floor. Oh no! Ooh. Alright, we're running into clipping issues, ladies and gentlemen. Looks like we're only going to be able to do a two-story building here because the tin roof of the airport is getting in the way. Look at that. I could still do a three-story one if I wanted to. I just have to remove that last line. Because I think that last line is the only one that's getting in the way of what we're wanting to do here. Let's see. Yeah, that's a little close. Ah! Yeah, that's a little close. Well, maybe our lives will get easier if we just remove this last line. It's going to make our vault a little smaller. But we'll at least... Now I gotta wait for this door. Ah, it's pushing me off! Yeah, we could remove this line right here. That's going to give us a four-tile width sort of living area, atrium. But that'll allow us to keep this top floor, which we can then build out later. So let's do that. If I can do that. I think I can do that. All right, we're going to need that later, so let's put that there. Let's move this. Yes, we can do that. Ha-ha! I love it when a plan comes together. Just move it on back, move it on back. One piece at a time, just move it on back. Oh no. Now, now, now. Okay, slowly. Yes! Yes, aha! And then, just move these back one by one. And this may actually end up looking nicer. See how this looks from the outside. We no longer need that trim piece. We can get rid of these excess supports. And okay, yeah, looking pretty good. We've got this concrete wall right there, which comes with the door. All right, now to finish off the walls here, and then once I finish that, I'll probably end this recording, because I don't want it to get too long. But a corner piece there. Corner piece there. Now we're going to want some of this wonderful natural light. So I'm going to have a lot of nice windows. Happy little windows in my world. You can have any world you want to be. This is your canvas. And in my world, I'm going to have happy little windows. All right, we should finish off this top floor here. Okay, so this is what it's going to look like. And maybe I could build a balcony out here. Well, that would be tricky. Well, maybe I will. Let's get our rooms done first. Okay, so we need to go to domestic hallway. Let's try a three-way, because for some reason I wasn't getting that one piece to snap. Alright. Set this here. Go to the doorway. Set that there. Then, domestic three-way. Get that there. Go to the end cap. Why does it want to snap? It's not close. It's not even close to the edge of the boundary. And there's nothing in the way. Why does it not want to snap? That is just going to make me mad. What can we do? What can we do? What can we do? What can we do? I mean, we could extend it with a hallway. See if that helps. And it does. What in tarnation? Why would that work, but that wouldn't? I don't know. There are just quirks and kinks in this whole system, ladies and gents. So let's go ahead and finish this off over here. Put a hallway. With an end cap, that's looking good. And then we can build some more rooms. Let's say that there are some luxury rooms over here. Maybe this top floor is for the elites of the settlement. You know, the 1%. The 1%ers who happen to live here. So let's go get a hallway with a doorway. Hallway and doorway. And we're gonna need two of these, but before we can put down that second one, let's build a hallway, and then go back to hallway with doorway. And then we can get another hallway. And finish that off with an end cap. Just like we did previously. Now, we need to build two more rooms. So let's go back to our rooms tile set. I suppose one of these could be a bathroom. The settlement is pretty tiny for a big bathroom structure. Well, I'll just do a domestic room here, quarters room, and then maybe in the future I could change this into a bathroom if I want. All right, let's choose a new wallpaper that we haven't used yet. We used that one. We have not used that one, so let's use that one. Good looking wallpaper. All right, let's find the corner pieces. I hate how these aren't set side by side. The wallpapers are really mixed up and muddled. All right, let's get a nice window. Oh yeah, view of downtown Boston. Look at that. Oh, that's gonna be so nice. I love the Boston Airport. It's such a cool settlement. All right. No, I need a regular corner piece with that wallpaper on it. There. Oh, and I forgot that one. Sweet. One room to go. Oh, I was going to use the luxury one, wasn't I? Oh, man. All right, maybe there will be only one luxury. All right, so we've got this blue luxury paper, this red luxury paper, and this white luxury paper. Let's go with the white luxury. Because it's got gold. Ooh, and marble floors. Man, these guys are ballin'. All right, let's get a corner with the window. Oh, and there's a green. Oh, well, I've already chosen white. Is there a corner with a window? Well, not with this tile set, huh? Okay. So I'll just need... I'll put a window in the sidewall here, yeah. That's where the window will go. And then we'll round this off with a few more corner pieces, and then we just need one wall piece, one more wall piece, and I believe that's it. Woo! Let's get ourselves some doors. Looking good, looking good. All right, we're gonna need some windows here. Clear window, black window, green window, pink window, red, regular. Wow. Gray, purple, yellow. That's a lot of different window options. I'm just gonna go basic. Let's go with a nice clear window. Nice clear window. Do we want a door there? Yeah, I suppose we need a door there. It is the wasteland after all. We don't want things to get drafty and irritated. And so let's add a door here. And this needs two windows. And this one needs one. Down to the final floor. And I think the cafeteria needs at least one window. Oh, a lot. Yeah, we put a lot of windows here in this cafeteria. I've always liked the idea of nice big open vaults. I don't want a vault that feels claustrophobic. So whenever I have the opportunity, I put in windows and open spaces just so that it feels so much better. Okay. We need to finish this off, and we do have a little bit of a conundrum here. Because... I don't know if I like this big blue hallway kind of sticking out. Now, we could avoid that by pushing this deeper in, but that would remove some of this interior space. Well, let's start. One thing at a time. Let's get a ceiling corner piece. Ceiling corner piece. Komsa. And that also is going to need to be... Now that's going to be a wall corner piece. So wall. Just a wall corner piece. Okay. And that's the same over here. A wall corner piece. No, that's different. Actually, no, it's the same. Okay, and then that's going to have to be a ceiling corner piece. Great, and now we can just build wall roofs. Stack those side by side. And then that is going to have to be just regular atrium walls. Now this needs to be an atrium doorway. We made that mistake earlier. And really, all I'm missing here is this. This doesn't feel right. That doesn't feel right. What can I do? Is there like a hanging ceiling or a hanging floor? I mean, what I could do is I could use a ceiling and a wall tile here and then put a floor on it, but it's really not designed to do that. That would make things really complicated. Let's see. Yeah, that's not gonna stick. That's designed for that. I suppose I could do it that way. Well, let's patch up the ceiling. Oh, look at that. And then I wanna try something. Okay, now that I've snapped that there, I can then nope, I can't. I wonder if I can just snap a floor there. Yes, I can! Oh, but then it clips. Oh well, that doesn't bother me. I don't care about that. That's gonna be fine. Now, I would like to put a pillar in there, but I don't think the pillar works in a corner piece. So can I snap this in the middle? And I can't. So I can only put a pillar on a floor if it's in the middle of the room, not if it's in a corner? Oh, that's bizarre. Oh well, that's the way it's gonna have to be. All right, let's finish this up. Let's go get the floor. Nice. And we're done, ladies and gentlemen. We are done. Now, obviously, I need to wire this with electricity. And this is just a basic domestic place. I've got four different bedrooms. Maybe each bedroom could house three or four different settlers. I've got a cafeteria down here. I could put a kitchen in that corner and then an eating area over here and then a lot of food storage. And then this could be a big open space. Maybe I could have some scavenging stations or some garden plots on the inside here. But then again, I also have this whole outdoor section and I could put a bunch of stuff out here. Now, taking a look at the outside here, it looks nice. It looks like something you'd see in like 1960s Moscow or something, building all of these little modular apartment complexes. looking pretty good around the whole corner here. And there's the atrium part of the vault. Oh, looks like I need to place a support over in this corner. I'll take care of that. But, alright, I think I'm gonna leave that as it is. I love this door. I love being able to use this this vault door. And I also love the fact that you don't have to power it. No, that doesn't make any sense from a logical perspective. But it just makes things a lot easier. I mean, imagine if raiders came and cut out your generators. Well, then your door wouldn't work and you wouldn't be able to get in or out of your vault. That's right, I had to extend these. I had to extend these in order to put the end cap. So I'll just put a support right there and stack it directly beneath that, and that should make it functional. Okay, I'm pretty pleased with how this turned out. It's a short, simple little vault. This video, just a basic demonstration on how you can build your own vault outside of Vault 88 if you want to. And we built it together, so I hope that was fun for you. It was certainly fun for me. If you have any questions about this video, how it came together, or anything else about Vault Tech Workshop, please let me know in the comments below. Do you have any suggestions on how I can improve this little vault that I put together? Let me know. Maybe I'll incorporate some of those suggestions into a future video. If you like what you saw, please subscribe for more content like this. And at the end of the day, I'm just so glad that you're watching. Thank you all very much, and I'll see you soon.